Who were the first Americans? Well, for many decades, academics claimed to have the answer. The Clovis first theory, which refers to the Clovis culture. We don't know how they called themselves, so the name comes from the region where the remnants were found. That is, of course, Clovis, in New Mexico. According to this theory, Paleolithic hunter-gatherers entered North America from the Northasian mammoth steppe, via the Beringian Bridge, which had formed between northeastern Siberia and western Alaska due to the lowering of sea level during the last glacial maximum. These populations expanded south of the Laurentine Tideshift and spread rapidly southward, occupying both North and South America by 12,000 to 14,000 years ago. So the Clovis culture was thought to represent the earliest human presence in the Americas, but many findings contradict the idea, like, for example, the latest at the Paleontological and Archaeological site of Pilauco, in Chile. Let's talk about it. Welcome to Ancient Puzzles. Okay, so we're back with another news episode. Once again, seems like the Clovis first theory is being challenged, and Pilauco was already important for the discovery of one of the earliest, if not the earliest, human footprints ever found in the Americas. A single footprint estimated to be 15,600 years old. That's very old, especially considering that southern Chile was one of the last areas humans reached, according to the Clovis model. This is probably why the finding was not exempt from criticism, although the group of scientists working at the site still defend the age of the footprint. And not only that. Another one dating back to 14,200 years has been added to the list, thought to correspond to a 7-year-old child. But something even older than these footprints has been found. A basalt stone artifact, which experts concluded it's over 17,000 years old. According to Dr. Mario Pino, geologist and leader of the team involved in the excavations, this was used as a brush to polish wood, and at the other end, it would fit as a crusher to break. I honestly can't tell, but they are surely familiar with this kind of stuff. It is also important to remark that this artifact was reported 1 year ago in the Lithic Technology magazine, but until 3 weeks ago, the rest of the media didn't seem to care, so for most people, it's a new discovery. And well, I noticed some articles show a different stone, but doesn't look like basalt, and after checking many of them and reading the information, the fragment of the thumbnail seems to be the correct one. And now, can we trust the edge of this discovery, or sediment mixing makes it look much older than what really is? That's a good question after the publication of a study by the scientific journal, Plus One, 2 months ago approximately, and covered on the Ancient Architects channel. I recommend you to check the video in question for more details and subscribe, if you haven't yet, to this amazing and very well-known channel. That being said, the study basically says sediment mixing was affecting some of the sites where Pre-Clovis presence was reported. Experts concluded sediment mixing is low at sites in Alaska, but sites in the south, below the ice sheets, show quite the opposite, meaning the age of the discoveries must be taken with a grain of salt. So, if that's correct, it could be that the 17,000-year-old artifact is not as old as the scientists in Chile claim. But I think it's possible they already took this factor into account. The 15,600-year-old footprint, as I said, was not accepted by the entire scientific community. Some experts thought it was weird to recover only a single footprint, expecting to basically find a trackway. But Karen Moreno, biologist and paleontologist, and again, Mario Pino, cited sediment mixing over time as the likely cause. They were both leading the research in question, and all the observations and experiments conducted were published in PLOS One, the same scientific journal where the recent study, revising Pre-Clovis presence in the Americas, was published. So it looks like scientists at Pilauco are at least familiar with this peculiarity, but it would be interesting if they could give more details on why their conclusions are not inaccurate. Note also that Pilauco is very close to Monteverde, another important site where Pre-Clovis traces have been reported. And one last thing. Signs of a cosmic impact during the Younger Dryas seem to be present at Pilauco, so it's a very complete site when it comes to new discoveries and theories emerging in the last 20 years. I personally think the Clovis first theory, even if not dead yet, will not last much longer. The topic became very popular thanks to Graham Hancock's books and talks, presenting other possible Pre-Clovis evidence and claiming that archaeology below the Clovis level was pretty much ignored for decades. According to him, there was maybe an advanced civilization before the Clovis people in the Americas, and it's only a matter of time to find its remnants now that archaeologists are studying the older levels. but so far, in both North and South America, only primitive and basic elements are coming out, and even the more advanced artifacts from Siberia, 20 to 25,000 years old, and extensively covered on the Ancient Architects channel, do not match what we would expect from a lost advanced civilization. We'll see in the coming years, though, if new discoveries change that. That's all, guys, and hope the video was interesting. Drop a like if you enjoyed, post a comment, and consider subscribing if you haven't yet. More content soon. Bye!